minority here. But I've thought this for years because many, many years ago, we had a ticket host who proclaimed that ESPN was ruining sports for him. And I agreed. And over the years, I just think ESPN has amped things up to a ridiculous degree. Every pregame show has to have 42 people on the set. They have to throw all sorts of bells and whistles at us, and I think I've always had the feeling that they were too big for their britches, and I think what's happened in the last couple of years, they've had two massive rounds of layoffs because they're losing money. One ESPN executive says, we're not really losing money, we're just not making as much as we used to. That's why we're having to lay off a lot of our big names, and we're trying to cut back on the budget, and we're doing all this. And I'm sensing a little ESPN backlash. I've had that feeling for a long time. And this is, you know, in the late 70s and the 80s, this was God's gift to the sports fan. Are you kidding? A 24-hour sports network, and we couldn't get enough of ESPN.
Yeah.
And Chris Berman and Bob Lee and Dan Patrick and Keith Olbermann were icons, and we loved them, and they were trailblazers, and they did their own thing. And Berman was unique because he had his own thing. He had his shtick. And Patrick and Olbermann had their shtick. And I think what happened to ESPN over the years was every single person they hired had to felt like they had to come up with their own shtick. And it started to beat me down after a while. And now you can't find anybody that just delivers you the straight story. Everybody's got to have their own catchphrase, whether it's forced in or not, or noise or shtick. And they've got so many personalities, so you've got 200 people all trying to force their own shtick with all these visual bells and whistles. And to me, it's just gotten to be too much. And now, the latest thing on ESPN is that everybody's got to be uber cool and uber street. And I am watching an NBA preview show about 2 or 3 weeks ago. And they're talking about the MVP race. And I look at the screen, and do you know what they had at the bottom of the screen with the words across the bottom of the screen in big letters? It read, "This LeBron's last chance to win MVP?" question mark. Not, "Is this LeBron's last chance to win MVP?" "This LeBron's last chance to win MVP?" question mark. They are so cool now at ESPN, they couldn't even use the word "is." "This LeBron's last chance to win MVP?" And you know what the next one was? The next subject and the graphic down below read, "Steph gonna ball out this year?"
Oh no, wasn't it?
Yes.
Was it really?
Yes. "This LeBron's last chance to win MVP?" question mark. Go to the next subject. "Steph gonna ball out this year?" question mark. They're so cool.
I think that's pretty good writing, actually.
That now on the CG below, they've got to put on the graphic, it's got to be in street lingo. Do they think that's the only way they're going to relate to their audience? That you got to drop the word "is."
They're trying to be young and hip because they've seen the numbers fall off, so they're grasping at some point. I still consume them, but every night I used to, like every other male in America, I used to watch SportsCenter. I don't make that a point of my everyday viewing habits now. I still watch some of their shows, though.
You know, I almost never watch SportsCenter anymore because I'm hit over the head with hipness. And everybody's got, you know, they're moving around the set all the time, and they're firing all these hip phrases at you, and they're dancing, and there's all these bells and whistles, and now it's even crept into the play-by-play. This is from the Texas-Iowa State game. This is Steve Levy, who's been there for a long time. He never used to be like this. But now he's forcing all these hip phrases into his play-by-play, and he was talking about the Iowa State quarterback that had the long hair.
I mentioned the salad and the flow of Jacob Park over the years. Here he is, high school student, Goose Creek, South Carolina. He's got the flow flying out of the helmet, and if he takes off and runs,
I don't think I've seen Levy talk more about another guy's hair than this week.
So 90-year-old Steve Levy is now using terms salad. salad and flow.
Not just saying, the guy's got long hair. Look how long his hair is coming out of the back of his helmet.
I've been telling you a long time about the salad and flow this kid's got.
They are ruining sports for me. Amen.
Yeah, you do sound a little old manny. I'm with you on some of those points. I still like some of their shows, though. And, yeah, I just don't give them the time that I used to, for sure. All right, 9:49 on the ticket. I do believe Norm's back today. We'll say hi.